And we're live. Hello, everyone. This is Yamino, the artist of Sister Claire, who is currently being drowned out by the sink. And I'm joined today by...
the one, the only, the incredible, the indelible, Ash Barnes.
And our friend Sarah.
Hello.
That's all I got.
And special guest who's washing the dishes. Get over here, special guest.
Wait, is this...
We're recording, right? There's no video, though. But just talk to the computer.
I'm David, Yamino's brother.
He came here from England, and he's going to be living with us for a while. So expect to hear him in future streams.
David's just like, I'm David.
It's like Sarah. I'm Sarah.
I'm Sarah.
I'm Groot.
That's my name.
Look at our full cat.
What's the cat doing? Oh.
When you went upstairs, Elena, all she wanted to do was to stand in the kitchen and cry. Even though I was like, hello, Winkle, I'm over here. She was like, I want you. I want mama.
I want mama. Not mama.
So this is the sketch for the previous wallpaper, because this is my template for wallpapers, but I'm going to delete that, and I'm starting on this month's wallpaper, which normally I have at least the sketch ready, but I haven't had time to work on it yet, so you guys are going to get to see this one from the initial concept. I'm probably only going to have time to do the sketch tonight, but maybe tomorrow we can continue inking and coloring. So what was the idea? It was going to be something involving fireflies.
Didn't you want...
I can't remember if it was going to be Claire or Clementine. Clementine was featured really recently.
I thought you said it was going to be Claire and cats and fireflies. And you were wondering as to whether you were going to draw Claire with...
Mm-hmm.
God, I got the wrong fingernails!
Stop yourself. I'm going to look at some pictures for... ideas. We caught some fireflies just last night. It was really cool.
We sure did.
Well, we didn't catch that many.
No.
This is a bit misleading.
They also weren't that cute.
Oh, I don't know. They were about this cute.
Okay.
We caught some really big ones that Sarah said were the girls. And
I
then there was
so.
A lot
I forgot
of
to look it up,
tiny little boys.
Elena, you're being blamed for the baby.
I don't know nothing about no baby.
Are you really sure Elena's the one you should be blaming?
This is a cute, dreamy kind of layout. Maybe I'll do something like that. I like those colors. Oops. What did I do? So the beginning of my process is usually looking at pictures for reference, and in this case, since I haven't had a lot of time to even think about the composition, I'm looking at other pictures involving nighttime and fireflies to think about a color palette and the composition of the picture. Sometimes doing a night picture is kind of difficult because you need the colors to be dark enough, especially if something's going to be glowing in the picture. It has to be dark, but not so dark that everything is washed out. Oh, there's a Ghibli movie with fireflies. Oh, there. Grave of the Fireflies. I've never watched it. I just know that it's really sad.
Yes, it is.
And I know that it involves some kind of candy tin.
Mm-hmm.
Because I had that candy tin. I had it, and everybody at SCAD got sad when they saw me eating candies out of it, and I'd be like, oh,
yeah,
sorry.
They sell it at every Asian supermarket ever.
Yeah.
I'm like, here, have trauma. Rattle, rattle.
Do you need a chair, David? Why don't you pull the chair over here? Oh, wow, that is a very bright night picture. You can tell this picture was taken in the daytime, and then they edited it to try to make it look like dark. I think like this is a good composition. I can do some cool blurry effects. I really like this depth of perspective. The atmospheric perspective is very nice.
Just be careful with all the trees. You know how you get with drawing trees.
Well, I can make a brush for this.
5,000 years later. Helena's like, why?
Yeah, maybe I'll just do it in a field. But I love that perspective. Oops, not Skype. I love that atmospheric perspective. You can't really get that if it's just a field. But... You want to sit here, David?
I can scooch a little. I don't think anyone is having a hard time hearing me. Or it might be better if y'all scooch, because otherwise David's going to hit this assortment of tools.
I'm stuck against the table here.
Is this okay? Meanwhile, the chat here is... Meanwhile, I drop all of my notes.
Oh, and you saw Perfect Blue, right?
Yeah, I've seen Perfect Blue. It kind of horrified me. I didn't have any desire to rewatch it.
I've never seen it.
Perfect Blue is a horror movie. It's animated. Well, I don't know if people would consider it horror. Like, it's psychological thriller slash horror. It's by the same... What's that name of that director who did...
Akira.
No, not Akira. No, he died recently.
The guy who did Paprika?
Yes, exactly. It's by that.
Kon Satoshi.
Oh, yeah, they just said it in the chat. Satoshi Kon, that's right.
Wow. Smoosh asks, so for real's question, how probable are whale witches in the Sister Claire universe? I've been wanting to make these kids of OCs. Honestly... any human who tries to venture much into the water is in for a real hard time. Merpeople and humans in the Sister Claire world don't get along.
I mean, you're welcome to make any OCs you want, but it would be unlikely if you're asking if it could be canon.
Yeah.
As you can see with Claire's visit to the underwater world,
so,
merpeople really don't like humans. And they would probably consider it, like, cultural appropriation for a human to try to turn into a merperson.
Any whale witches would have to be really bad at.
They'd have to be really good at being whales.
Dory tries speaking whale and they can't reply, or they have, like, a bad accent.
You're out of my ocean. Gabby's
clear. Their test.
Gabby's kind of a really big exception among mer people.
Lara asked if I'll draw the tiger shard. I don't know if it will be in this picture, although I guess I could, but it won't be canon then. Claire's not interacting with it anytime soon.
Good question, though. It's a nice world-building question.
Maybe I can work some ruins into this picture.
Good idea.
Any chicken witches?
Yeah,
actually, David, we just introduced a chicken witch. Actually,
her name is Henny.
Henrietta.
You're not good. You're just a chicken.
Hunter asked, Ash or Elena, how are the appliances of your place? Refrigerator, oven, stove, dishwasher? They all exist and they are fine, except for the refrigerator, which the light in it does not work.
I'm pretty sure our toaster is haunted.
We have a toaster.
There's a toaster?
Oh, the toaster
oven.
I think
you're just imagining.
It's the ghost of a toaster that once was. Whenever I put toast in it, it becomes semi-transparent. And my hand just passes right through it.
Laura asked, no, did the tiger shard hightail it? I was looking forward to them.
Oh, I mean, you're going to see the tiger shard again, just not anytime soon. It's kind of a, what's the word I'm looking for? You know, like any cat, it's kind of fickle.
Aloof.
Yeah.
Also, something really intense just happened to it, like most cats.
And it woke up in the water, so.
Yeah.
With your mouth open.
Zeke is our dog, by the way.
Hunter said, man, without reading the missing moments anymore, I feel like I'm missing so much. Well,
you really are.
Yeah, that's why they're called missing moments. They, you know, help out with things that are otherwise missing.
David, stop creaking your chair.
Oh, winkle. Winkle.
Say hi.
Okay.
Okay.
Hunter, why would you read the normal pages but not read the missing moments?
Just you're cheating yourself out of half of the story.
Just out of curiosity.
Got like a handful of fur. Excuse me.
If you don't like the direction of the missing moments, I'm not sure you're going to like the direction of the comic in general, because they're sort of, they're crossing over more and more now.
Can't please everybody. Hunter, if you don't like magpies, I got some bad news for you. You might want to prepare your body. Yeah. Did you really think magpie was going to stay just in the missing moments? Oh, well.
Magpie fans are cawing with glee. I'm gonna go upstairs to finish my homework.
Okay.
But I'll be back.
We'll miss you, Sarah.
I won't have any fun without you.
Don't. Never. Don't stay parted from us for long, Sarah.
Don't
I don't know if I'll make it.
You know, I'll be right upstairs. It's just not the same. You can hear my angry noises over physics. It'll keep you coming. I'll be back.
Angry Sarah noises.
Bye, Chad. See you soon.
What? Smoosh asked if Magpie's gonna be hot. I guess I'll leave that up to y'all.
If you want to hang with him, he'll give it one shot.
Stop that. Stop that.
Hearing the parade of Wingle's feet just going all over our living room. One day she's going to knock down the cat tree, though.
I look forward to that day.
I just hope it's not in the middle of the night when all of a sudden, crash, bang!
I hope it happens. I hope it happens when I'm right there watching.
Yeah.
She'll glare at you accusingly.
Yeah.
This was your fault. Laura asked, do you girls have any idea how many shard cats there are, or is it just a bunch of named one and then lots more? There's a lot of shard cats.
I guess there's around 30 to 40.
Mm-hmm.
But there's only, like, a few that I constantly show, like, that people will recognize. There's Snowy, and there's Grim, and there's the Sailor Cats. And there's Dismas and Gestas, who are kind of the twins' cats. I haven't shown them recently. Maybe I should. Oh, I'm glad you like Sailor Mew, Calandra. It was too fun not to use. You should answer some of those questions, Ash.
Mm-hmm. Sean asked, will the upcoming Clem shards be as big as the recent one that became a horned tiger? Sean's going off the theory that Clementine spawned several shards upon her death. And I can say that there are other big shards out there. We'll see if we meet them. Calandra asked, how many shards are there in the world? Is there a known number?
No. They're made all the time.
Mm-hmm.
It's like asking how much pain is there in the world. It's not something that is static and can be measured.
Yeah. Diane asked, will we get to see the outer Senshi kitties soon?
You technically already have, but just in silhouette. You will eventually get to meet those.
Hmm.
I've designed them. I actually designed them years ago.
Cephalopod Queen asked if we're recording. Yes, we are.
Yeah.
So you'll definitely be able to listen to this on YouTube later if your audio is currently not behaving. Mm-hmm. Oh, what a great question. Benicula asked, was Magpie's ability to soothe Sparrow an effect of Clementine's proximity, or simply that a singular shard like that can be calmed by anyone with the will and situational knowledge? The latter. Clementine's presence had nothing to do with Magpie's ability to calm Sparrow. I mean, Clementine helped Magpie find Sparrow. But, and also helped, I guess if Clementine did anything, it was, No, I'm going to say that was pretty much all Magpie, which has a lot of interesting implications for the rest of the story, doesn't it? Skeleton King asked, just wondering, are there any dragons or wyverns in the world of Sister Claire?
None that we have planned. I think probably the closest things would be creatures like the shard that they just fought.
We've mentioned them in...
I wouldn't write it out, but we haven't really planned for any.
Yeah, like, they've been mentioned in fairy tales and stuff that, like, the twins and Claire were reading.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's entirely possible that they exist or have existed, but like Elena said, we may or may not show them. At the moment, we don't have any plans to. But hey, I like dragons. And I know Elena's quite fond of dragons.
Mm-hmm. If we do include any dragons, they'll probably be something, something we show in relation to the Helsings, because they're monster hunters.
Mm-hmm. The Helsings, regarding them, you will see mythical creatures tied to the Helsings.
Mm-hmm.
I'm really excited about that. Very excited. Cephalopod Queen asks, so, there may be more than two people who can understand shards in the right situations? Yes.
It really has to be the right situation,
it,
though.
It really does.
And the person in question has to have a tie to whoever created that shard to understand. They have to know what their pain is.
Mm-hmm. Or at least be able to relate to it enough that they can make that connection.
Hey, I microwave for a minute.
Yeah. Skeleton King said, what about wyverns? Do you also like them? I like pretty much anything.
How's that different from a dragon?
A wyvern looks a little different. They don't tend to have the four legs.
Oh, so it's like a lindworm.
Yeah. I mean, sometimes they do still have wings.
Uh-huh.
Like a pterodactyl.
Yeah. They're awesome. They look, anything that looks like a flying dinosaur, or like a dinosaur in general, has my vote for yes.
Smoke.
I tend to be more of a fan of the kinds that have four legs, but I'm not, like, racially biased against dragons with less than four legs. I just liked four, because I always like to think of Maleficent as a dragon, and she was always my favorite.
Mm-hmm. In relation to what Magpie did for Sparrow, Smoosh said, what we saw was really rare then, huh? Yes, it was. Oh, I'm fine. No, I'm fine.
Are you eating my biscuit?
Yeah.
Go ahead. Go ahead and eat my biscuit. Maybe it's fine. You can eat it. I can't eat it right now anyway.
Ashley said, "Hi, Ash. Hi, Elena. Is Sarah there, too? I'm afraid I don't know who the other person is. I've never heard that voice before, and I just showed up to the stream. The strange voice you hear will not be strange at all very soon. This is Elena's brother, David."
And a mustard on it.
Oh.
There.
I know I should eat.
It's just I've, a part of
yeah, I'm
person.
I'm caught up on the comic, but I'm I still need to catch up on missing moments. I vow to devote more time.
You better
it's
vow.
Okay. It's okay, baby.
If you break that vow, you can't live with us anymore.
Can't stay with us.
Someone asked what the age difference between me and David is. It varies between 3 and 4 years.
Right.
Like, when you
yeah,
subtract
like,
our ages, sometimes it's 3 years and sometimes it's four.
It's like, yeah.
It's like 3 and a half,
on,
I suppose.
It depends on the month.
Yeah.
3 to 4 years. And Flash Gordon asked, "So, if Sister Claire became a TV show, who would Ash and Yamino voice?"
I would totally voice one of the twins. I mean, I'm just saying I could totally do it.
You'd be Rosalie.
Probably. I'd be the bitchy one.
You're the mean.
I can't lie.
You'd be the mean one. I don't know who I would voice. I don't really sound like any of the characters. So.
We could find something for you. No, but really, if there was a Sister Claire movie, I want Kesha to voice Rosalie, and I want Taylor Swift to be Marie. And I want Janelle Monáe to be Jackson. I want...
Lupo could be, like, Tommy Wiseau or something.
God, no. I'd rather voice Lupo than Tommy Wiseau.
Oh, hey, Ozzy. Sounds like you're the expert.
Aw. Calandra just gave me a really nice compliment. This is, I know this seems odd, Ash, but I think of your voice when I think of Mamu.
Aw.
I don't sound a thing like her. But that's really sweet. That's so nice. I'm glad.
Lara, I said that I wanted Kesha to voice Rosie. Because when I listen to Kesha music, it sounds like Rosie to me.
Hunter asked, "Ash, how early do you have to be up for work? Do the streams never mess with your sleep?" Darling, Sister Claire messes with my sleep every day. But I have to be up... Well, it depends. During the summer, I don't have to be at work until 9. During the like fall and spring semesters, I have to be at work at 8:30. So... I get up between 7 and 8, depending. The bus ride takes a while.
That guy from Gotham asked if we ever dream about Sister Claire.
Yes.
I can't remember the last time I did, but I know I have.
I dream about Clementine. I haven't dreamed about them, like, constantly or anything.
I'm having Grim poised on Claire's leg, how Winkle likes to sit on our couch.
It's all ready for butt pats.
Yeah.
I wish I could voice a character. Sister Claire thing, but I really don't sound like any of them. I could voice a cat.
Smoosh asked if Grim likes spanking. Probably. Well, I don't know. Spanking for Grim might be a little bit, might bring post-traumatic stress reactions, since Grim is a shard that was formed from abusive parents. I don't know. All I know is that my cat, who reminds me a lot of Grimm, definitely loves getting spanked. It's like her favorite thing.
Skeleton King asked, are by any chance dragons friends or allies with witches? And this is in general, like a general question. To be perfectly honest, I wouldn't think they would be allies with witches. I think if they were going to be allied with anyone, it would be the Helsing Abbey.
I don't know about that. I actually think it's a valid thought to consider that they might help witches.
Sorry.
Because if dragons are hunted by Helsings and witches are hunted by Helsings, and if we're going with the idea that dragons here are cognizant and can talk and stuff, I'm sure they'd be intelligent enough to try to strike some kind of, whatchamacallit, like a deal with witches to help each other out.
Mm-hmm.
That sound earlier was Ash doing the cat voice.
Yeah. Flash Gordon said, Sister Jackson for Ash. Sorry, darling, I am not black. I would not begin to try to voice a black character. Though I do, like, Jackson's accent is definitely a southern accent, and I base it on myself. But I wouldn't try to speak for her in any other way. It's one thing to write dialogue, it's entirely another to give a character a voice. Someone asked a question earlier about our pets. What was it? Oh, Sean asked, is Zeke your dog, and what is the name of the other cat? Zeke is definitely our dog. He's a dachshund. And we have Winkle, the little gray and white cat. And we also have Aang, the Siamese cat, who is very fat and currently sprawled on his back at the threshold of our living room, hoping one of us will put a foot in his belly so he can go and claw it.
Here. Let's see.
David's getting Aang to sing for you. David doesn't have a cat. All the pets here are ours. Sarah doesn't... Well, actually, yeah, Sarah does live with us currently, but only for a few months while she's doing summer school. We have two extra rooms. It's a three-bedroom place that we live in, and because it would have been easier for her to afford if she had a place close to campus, we're letting her stay with us for a while.
We added her to the family.
We had an IKEA trip today. Baby's first trip to IKEA.
Hunter says I have a deep southern drawl. I never thought so, but okay. I take that as a compliment.
It comes out more at certain times.
Mm-hmm. If someone cuts me off while I'm driving. Hunter asked, three bedrooms? Did you do that with the plan of having roommates? Well, actually, yeah, we knew David was coming to live with us in a couple months, so we definitely wanted to have space for him, and we, at the time, we didn't realize Sarah was going to be staying with us for any length of time, so...
The third room is going to be our office when she moves out.
Our office, the place where I will overwinter plants,
and our guest room.
Yeah, and the place where we will stash guests, should they decide to come stay with us.
What's wrong, David?
Calandra asked, is it too personal to ask why David is in the States?
We love David.
I'm also gonna be doing my my honors project with someone from UNC. Yeah, there's a lot of planning to do this month, but yeah, it has to do with seagrass and stuff, but be right back.
What David didn't say is that he's a smart cookie.
Mm-hmm.
Kalandra asks, do Snowy and Grim get along or hate each other?
They don't really get along.
At the outset, they really didn't like each other, but I'm pretty positive that as time goes on, Grim will at least learn to tolerate Snowy.
Mm-hmm.
Snowy is also not, Snowy's not quite on the same level as Grim, exactly. All I can tell you, darling, is that you will see what I mean when I say that. Snowy's a cat. Grim is a little bit more.
Snowy is, too.
I know, but...
Snowy's more than a cat.
I know, but things that you will see Grim do, probably you will never see Snowy do. That's why I said probably. Ellen is giving me this, sideways look.
I'm like, I don't know. I've designed some things that I think would be cool to fit in.
I know. Sean asked, will Sarah maybe pop in at some point during this live draw? She was here earlier. She had to leave to do some homework, but she will return.
Sorry, I'm watering the creatures.
Cross X Hunter asked if I write the dialogue scenes or if it's all Ash. It really depends. Ash isn't the writer in that she writes the entire script.
Mm-hmm.
We kind of co-write stuff, but when we do the dialogue for the pages, it's usually me having drawn the entire page with a vague idea of what the dialogue is going to be and be like, hey, Ash, help me with the dialogue. And then we talk about it. There isn't really a line between who does specifically what, except that I specifically draw and Ash specifically writes the missing moments. But other than that, when it comes to writing the comic, it's really...
joint effort.
Yeah. It's a symbiotic relationship. Laura asked if David is pronounced differently in Italian. Yeah, except because his name is the English David, it's not Davide. Nobody really calls him that. My dad used to when he was little, but we pretty much call him David. But if he had the Italian... he's named after our American grandfather, who's named David Anthony. And if David had the Italian name, he'd be called Davide.
Flash Gordon said, I wonder if there'll be a shout-out to Steven Universe in the comic at some point. Well, we both really love Steven Universe.
If I ever need to draw some dogs, they'll probably be the Crystal Dogs.
There you go.
Well, I think friends is a bit too familiar of a term, but I am followed by some of the voice actresses from Steven Universe on Twitter, and they talk to me very occasionally.
They're really nice.
But it's not like I have their phone number and I call them up constantly and I'm like, hey. They are really super nice people, though. I really hope that if we ever go to LA that we can meet them, or at least meet Michaela Dietz. She seems to be the most interested in hanging out with me, potentially, if we end up there. I told her I would draw her a picture of Amethyst as a pug if we meet up in person.
Smoosh asked, Ash and Yaminom, do either of you know about Life is Strange? Sarah and David can also answer. Sarah and David are currently upstairs, so I'm sure they'll be back. I've seen some gifs and stuff of Life is Strange on Tumblr, but I don't know much about it besides that.
I've never heard of it. I think it's
a game.
Oh.
The thing is, though, like, I don't really play games. Sometimes I'll watch a Let's Play. But, yeah, I'm not big into the gaming scene.
Skeleton King asked if there's any other characters like Gabrielle. Well, if there were going to be, it would be a real spoiler to tell you, so...
We can't say.
Yeah. I can tell you something that won't happen, though. Originally, I was planning to have Gabrielle be, like, part of a trio of archangels, and there was going to be an angel that was representing Uriel, who is the angel of death, the same one who killed all the firstborns in the, the Prince of Egypt story. But that idea has been scrapped, so if that's what you're asking, well, no. I think it's been made pretty clear by now, if you've caught up with the comic, and especially... with the current chapter that's about to come out, you're going to realize that Gabrielle is not... Calling her an angel is kind of an oversimplification.
Yeah. You're going to find out a lot about Gabby really soon. We're very excited.
I need to pull up a picture of Claire in the latest pages so that I can draw her accurately. So spoilers for anybody who's not caught up yet.
Flash Gordon asked if Gabby is a purified shard. No.
Good guess, but no. She's not a cat. Not that all of them all have to be, but that's usually the big tip-off. Feline characteristics, probably a purified shard.
Ryan said, I really like how the missing moments in main comic are dovetailing recently. I'm really glad you enjoyed that, because the comic and the missing moments are soon going to begin to fold together as fingers do.
Nice description.
It's what I do.
What does dovetailing mean?
It's when wood inlay folds together. I can show you.
So, are the missing moments catching up chronologically?
Not quite yet, but a lot of events that are, you know, happening in the missing moments are becoming increasingly relevant to the immediate comic pages.
Mm-hmm.
They're sort of syncing up in that. The similarities between Claire and Clementine are really coming to the fore.
Kalandra asked, if this is too spoilery, please ignore, but is Claire a reincarnation or something else? Like saying Gabby is an angel is an oversimplification is also, like, that same, like, oversimplification can be applied to saying Claire is a reincarnation. So, our answer is, wait and see. That's a good question.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
She's so pretty.
Aw, thank you, lovely art time. Sister Gabby has a question.
Go for it. Laura asked, girls, if Clem had stopped purifying shards for a while, would the horns have eventually fallen off and stopped regrowing? More likely, they would have just not grown anymore and stayed there. The horns fall off when she can't handle it anymore.
It's kind of like her shedding, like, you know, the black stuff that came out of Catherine when she threw up all of that, like, pain and built up bad feeling that she had swallowed from Marguerite. That kind of builds up in Clementine's horns.
Mm-hmm.
They're sort of her body externalizing all of that awfulness so that it doesn't have to be kept inside her. And they fall off only so that she can grow new ones.
Calandra said, out of curiosity, why horns?
Because they're awesome.
They're awesome. They're really... they're easy to show. Things like pain collecting have been shown in lots and lots of other stories. Like characters who can take pain from other people or who can suck up pain in general. Sometimes it's shown as, like, different coloration. I've seen tattoos... horns are just really nice.
And like Flash said, they have a pagan element,
exactly.
Which is a big reason why I like them.
Mm-hmm.
The horned one is actually like a pagan god.
Mm-hmm.
So it works to reuse that as a witch leader.
Sister Gabby said, I think I read one of you saying that all of the Sister Claire characters are queer. Does that include Claire? Let's see, what else? Does she have a love interest, or will she?
No.
No.
Ash looks at me expectantly. We've talked about this. Claire is ace, but that is on the queer spectrum, so.
Yeah.
She's queer, but that doesn't mean that she is into ladies, if that's what you're asking. I mean, I think we've talked about whether Claire could have a romantic interest, and I really think that in her current situation, she could not focus on something like that.
No.
I mean, can you imagine going through what she's going through and being worried about having a crush on someone? Like,
well, other characters will, but I think...
Yeah, but they're not going through specifically what she is.
No.
She's going to start wondering who she even is anymore. Like,
yeah.
It's kind of heavy shit.
it really is. But Claire is ace. I don't want to say, there's always a situation where a character could behave a different way, because that's not necessarily true. But...
I guess what I'm trying to say is that were she not in the situation she is now, I'm sure she would at least give it a try, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But since she doesn't really have the inclination to now, and nor does she have the time or mental energy, I don't think she's going to.
No. Claire is ace and aromantic.
That doesn't mean that she really craves, like, family and friendship, though. She's definitely someone who benefits from a nakama. But, you know, just because Claire is ace doesn't mean there aren't going to be any characters that are interested in Claire.
Yeah, that's also true. And, you know, I think it...
it's very important to say that Claire values the relationships that she has with people, you know, extraordinarily highly. They're just not romantic.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I've seen a lot of people shipping Claire and Marie. And
I think for Claire, it might be kind of hard to separate friendship feelings from romantic feelings because I don't think she has, like, the sex drive that
mm-hmm.
other people would also have in addition to that.
Mm-hmm.
So she might confuse friendship feelings for romance. I don't know. I mean, when I think about it, it's hard for me to decipher, like, what's the difference, really, between a really strong friendship and a romance
mm-hmm.
when you take away the sexual aspect of it.
Mm-hmm. It's hard for me, too. Like, I... Sometimes I think I got a handle on it, and then I sit there and try to think about it, and I'm like, nope, still befuddled.
Oh, Diane wants to know what ace means.
Oh, ace means asexual. It means you do not experience sexual attraction, or very rarely. The ace
spectrum.
Yeah, I was just, yeah, David got to it before I did. David was like, yeah. Sliding into home. There's a lot of different kinds of ace that you can be.
Maybe somebody should link to
yeah, let me see if I can find it.
Because there's some really good reading you can do about it.
Yeah.
If you have any questions.
There we go. I'm just gonna put this link in the chat unless everyone else has beaten me to it. There we go. Yeah. Give it a glance.
Do this somewhere else.
Hmm. Skeleton King asked, have either of you two seen the Black Cauldron? I wonder what Clementine would think of the Horned King.
She'd be like, stop ripping off my style.
She'd be like, ew. She does it bigger, better. She's also not evil. At least from her own perspective. I'm sure other people might disagree.
Well, neither is Abraham from her own perspective.
Yeah.
I don't think anyone in Sister Claire considers themselves evil.
Yeah.
Despite what some of their actions might say about them to others.
I think there are characters who are aware that what they're doing is despicable, but they feel like it's also necessary.
Yeah, I think there are characters who are aware that they cannot be forgiven for what they're doing, but I think they also feel like somebody's got to do it.
Yeah. Let's see. Ah, Sister Gabby said, but what about Lupo? If he is gay, then will he have a love interest? I think he is the only male character so far, right? Wrong! He is not the only male character.
He's not the only male character, and also, who said he was gay?
He's definitely not gay.
If you've read some of Ash's live rights, they're not missing moments, but we haven't mentioned it in canon yet.
Yes, we have.
Have we? Where?
Yep, in Fratelli. The New Year's special.
Oh, right. I was just forgetting, because that was actually a live right that you turned into a missing moment.
Mm-hmm. Well, people saw me live write it.
Yeah, but in that story, it's mentioned that Lupo is bi.
Mm-hmm.
He has tried and failed to date many kinds of people.
Yeah.
He's not picky about his failures. Like, Lupo just really likes hot people and wants somebody to like him.
I wouldn't even go so far as to say
it's not even that
hot.
He's like shallow and he wants like specifically hot people. He just wants people to like him.
Yeah.
And he's trying really and desperation is not cute.
No.
You have the screen very bright.
That's how I like it. It's bad for your eyes to make it dim and you gotta squint.
Hmm. Smoosh asked, is King Michelle bi as well? Uh-huh. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Which of the sailor cats is my favorite to draw? I don't know. They're all really fun to draw. I really like Fluffy Jupiter Cat, who I'm working on right now. I also really love Mercury Cat, who's basically like a dachshund cat. She's a Scottish fold munchkin cat.
Laura asked, did Claire and the twins ever, like, sit down and decide to become nuns? Or did it just feel like it was the most natural path? Did they ever consider other options, like, hell, being bakers? Do you want to take this one, Elder, or do you want my thoughts first?
Why don't you give your thoughts?
Well, I think for Marie and Rosalie, I think in large part they wanted to do what Oscar was doing. They've both idolized Oscar since forever. And to do something besides what Oscar was doing would have felt like kind of just not right. Rosie especially. Like, Rosie followed in Oscar's footsteps and Marie followed in Rosie's. Marie was never really able to conceive of doing something or being away from her sister to the point that they wouldn't be doing the same thing. And when you're talking about Claire and why she decided to become a nun, the thing is,
why she decided.
You could also hit pause and then it'll...
Something you might notice about Claire is that she never actually became a nun proper. Everyone might call her Sister Claire, but she's still a novice. So she was just trying it on. No one ever said that Claire didn't have other thoughts. I mean, Claire wanted a purpose in life. That's how the whole comic got started, you know? If Claire had ever had the thought that she was good enough at something else, I'm sure she would have pursued it.
Welcome back, Sarah.
Sarah's home.
Oh, yeah, Sean just said something that I should have mentioned. The twins took their vows and hid their gift. That's right. Like, a really big part of the reason that the twins became nuns is self-hatred. Feeling like they had to suppress their magic. They were taught from a very early age that magic was bad, that locking it away was the best thing to do.
That's some really solid reference there.
Yeah. I'll bring one of these forward a little more.
I see something about a Powerpuff Girls reboot.
Where? The 2016 reboot? Oh yeah, I've heard of that. I know someone who's working on it.
Oh, not you?
Not me.
Oh, no.
I wonder if the original voice actresses are on it.
Hmm.
They seem like they'd be a lot old now.
Yeah. Which cat
make
is that?
Full of crossovers.
This is the Sailor Mars cat, of course. She's the hunter cat.
I see.
This one, I guess, will be
Venus.
Sailor Venus cat. This is Sailor Jupiter cat.
No. Oh, who is that on the right of Claire?
That's silly. And Grim.
Well,
her slight wrinkle.
Yeah.
Oh, good. I'm glad that Claire's hand is on Grim's head.
Mm-hmm.
What was that noise?
This wrinkle sitting on a chair.
Yeah.
Being a fool.
Mm-hmm.
Someone asks, hey, Yamino, who would win a slam dunk contest between Oscar and Marguerite?
As in, like, slam, like, basketball?
Yeah.
Marguerite would just walk away. Yeah. She would forfeit her win.
I know she's, like, all about baskets and things like that, but I don't think basketball is quite her jam.
I didn't have time for this nonsense. And Oscar would be like, come on, it'll be fun, see? Whoosh, and make one basket, and she'll win, because that'll be the only one. And Rosie will, like, make a checkpoint and be like, well, I guess that means you win. Because technically she forfeited. Well, I wonder if who else would be good at basketball at the Abbey.
I know Olga would try, but Olga's so short.
Olga would, like, throw the basketball and it would make this hole. She'd have really good aim, but it'd be like...
She'd be one of those people who,
like,
tries
a cannonball.
Who tries to dunk and just shatters...
Rips the hole.
The whole thing. And
glass shards everywhere.
Yeah, and then she'd just be like... Oh.
I bet Jackson would be, like, so excited to show up, because I bet she'd think she's really good, and then she's like, oh, but you go first. She gives it to Olga, and Olga, like, destroys the hoop, and she's like, damn you.
Olga, this is why we can't have nice things.
This is my time to shine. And Olga's like, I'm sorry, I'll build you a new one, and she makes it out of, like, these really heavy-duty materials. But then she builds it, and it's really short, so nobody can do a proper slam dunk. Like, she makes it, like,
she's, like, the only one.
Yeah, yeah. Oscar just, like, puts it.
Oscar uses it as an armrest.
Everyone thinks Oscar is so nice, and yet every single time I've written Olga and Oscar interacting together, I've had Oscar tease Olga mercilessly about her height. I'm pretty sure that that's just every time she sees Olga, she's just like, yeah.
Your fans have been waiting for you to come back, Sarah.
Aww.
Is there a headless horseman in Sister Claire by any chance? Skeleton King asks. Don't know.
I did a sketch for Halloween.
I'm thinking Christopher Walken now.
I never finished this. It was going to be the Halloween Patreon picture. Or I think it'll probably still be... God, you guys.
Sorry.
For next October's Patreon picture, I do have a picture in mind. That's inspired by the Headless Horseman, but the horse woman will in fact not be headless.
Cephalopod Queen whispers, when will my audio return from the war?
Oh.
Oh, my dad did that home ash.
Oh, God. I was like, okay, look at these mystical pork chops. I was about to get really afraid because I didn't recall. Like,
yeah, no. You haven't just been in there for 3 months.
So I was like, oh, no. How long have these been in here?
No, they're very new, and they have teriyaki sauce on them, and they're available for your lunches, if you please.
I was going to be like, oh, God, I'm so glad the refrigerator light doesn't work.
Thank goodness they're not alive yet.
Someone only just now realized that Lemon Lamb is you.
Yeah, I dropped the bomb on that one.
You could have stayed anonymous.
What?
You could have.
Goodbye, Gabby.
Come on.
Good night, Gabby.
Come on. Sorry, y'all. Hey, wait. Joe, someone asked, will we ever see those two nuns from the first chapter ever again?
You've seen one of them, actually, in the Missing Moments.
If you read the Missing Moments, then you have seen Hinny.
We have no plans to bring Sister Agnes back.
Yeah.
She existed solely to piss.
She's not gonna be like a cow witch or something.
No.
Agnes. Such a cow name.
I don't know. Someone, you know, someone commissioned me on Patreon. I'll write it. I have thoughts. I have ideas. Joe said, hey, Yamino and Ash, are there demons in the world of Sister Claire? Or creatures or beings that get mistaken for demons? Like how people mistake Gabrielle for an angel.
Shards.
Shards. Michael.
This perfect symphony of
Winkle.
Just my stomach growling, don't worry about it.
Hey, Winkle, do you want to be on this month's wallpaper? Winkle.
I think Winkle and Aang should have cameos in Sister Claire.
Winkle, come here. Tell me, come here.
You can always tell which of us is saying the cat, the pet's names, because I'm like, Winkle.
And I say it like,
Anna says it so sweetly and softly, and Aang, or sorry, Ash, like, growls it at them.
Aang! Skeleton King asked, are there any pirates? Are there any ghost pirates? I'm not sure if there are ghost pirates, but
No. You can't have pirates if you don't have ghost pirates.
Well,
Ash, you gotta make it happen.
Maybe, we'll see. But there are pirates, yes.
Maybe, like, zombie robot pirate.
In my initial concept, I'd had ideas for nun pirates, like seafaring nuns who hunted merpeople, and that was going to be part of the reason why merpeople hate humans.
Dan asks, do you have any intention of putting your live rights and missing moments into a collective book?
Well, we do want to, but it's going to be kind of difficult because the missing moments kind of span, like, they are not sequential. And we've thought about collecting them all thematically, but the problem is that would kind of lock them down, so it would make it hard for us to do other missing moments that go between them. Because then it would be missing from the book, and, you know, it's kind of messy. Mm. The only way I could see to print them and have it organized exactly how we'd like would be to wait until the whole comic is over, and that's a long time to wait.
Mm-hmm.
And that would also mean releasing them as a collection. It would be thicker than, like, 5 Bibles, because Ash writes a lot.
Benicula asked, are there vampires at all? This is important. Yes, in the Sister Claire universe, they are called Blood Teeth.
Mm-hmm.
They were mentioned very briefly in a missing moment where Olga is trying to distract Claire from her stomachache. And someone else asked earlier, are there werebeasts? Oh, yes. You've met several.
Yeah, you have.
You've met Ozzy and Lupo.
I think Ozzy and Lupo should get their own wallpaper sometime soon.
I wanted to give them a fall wallpaper, but then I can't remember why. But oh, we ended up doing Magpie and Marguerite instead.
Mm-hmm.
But I had really wanted to do something with Ozzy and Lupo and fall leaves. I thought it would be really
It's
cool.
Not too late for next fall. It's coming up.
It's June.
It's like 3 months.
I should move everything to the side. It's a little too much of a middle.
Yeah. Move it to the left.
Excellent questions tonight, y'all.
Mm-hmm. What are you eating? It smells like cat food.
It smells like cat food.
It does.
It's
faintly.
A burrito bowl.
Oh.
Thank you very much. Got rice and avocado and mushrooms, cilantro, my delicious chicken.
Well, excuse
like
me.
About corned beef hash. Like duck food.
I don't know if I have the, I drew reference of the twins' cats once upon a time.
Hmm.
I'm just going to have to find a page that has them on it. Let's see, chapter 9. I don't know, chapter 8. Here's where I introduce Dismas and Gestas. And you see their eyes. Most of the time, they don't have their
I
eyes.
I wonder who is who.
I was just going to say, can you guess which one belongs to Marie and which one belongs to Rosie?
A werefox.
A werefox would be pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
I'd actually thought about, well, I can't really say too much without being spoilery, but I had considered, I don't know if I even mentioned this to you, Ash, but I had considered at a certain point in the story, if the twins had to disguise themselves as witches, that they could pretend to be fox witches.
Mm.
That could be good.
You have mentioned
that. Or that somebody would mistake them for such because they hang out with wolf witches.
Mm. I remember you telling me about that. A long time ago.
Oh, Winkle's looking at a bug.
Oh,
what kind of bug?
I don't know. As long as it stays away from my feet. Aw, Scruffy said, Ash, your green thumbs have inspired me. I've been working for the last 2 days to entirely de-weed my garden. Good on you. I need to go out and deadhead my petunia. I'm not really looking forward to that. Oh, hell. Okay, I didn't just drop rice on my computer like I thought. Hmm. Laura, that's a good question. Hey, has Lupo heard a lot of stories about Clementine growing up? Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Joe asked, is it a cool bug? It's a cute little earwig.
Oh, God.
You
should
have
seen. I didn't notice the pincers on the back.
It's a pretty small one.
You should have seen Elena and David's faces. They were both like.
Earwigs are one of my favorites. I think they're adorable.
I haven't really interacted much with earwigs ever since I ate one for a dare.
Oh, God, I want
to. Hey, it was a long time ago, okay? I have
day,
to say, it didn't taste nearly as bad as the ants that I ate for a dare after that. What just touched my leg? That better have been a tail. Okay.
To this day, I regret not trying those tequila lollipops with the mealworms.
You can get them here, you know.
Yeah, they're
you can get them at any Spencer's.
I get you one for your birthday.
I didn't eat insects and get chased by seals. That's Elena.
Yeah, that's me.
My childhood was relatively tame in comparison. Well, that's not true at all.
That's not true at all, Ash. We just had different kinds of adventures.
You
mine were self-inflicted.
Did you just put that on the table?
I'll take it outside, Ash. Whatever.
Ugh.
Sorry.
I just see Sarah walk over, drop an earwig on the table service, and walk away.
What are
Ash?
I forget people have, you know, biases against other animals.
Jeez, at least babysit your earwigs.
Oh. I was putting the paper I picked it up with back where it belonged.
Oh, okay.
Babysit your damn
earwigs. I'll do better next time.
get rid of the damn
fireflies. We had fun with fireflies last night.
Mm-hmm. That was a good time.
I'm glad that was so memorable.
Rid of the damn fireflies.
Ashes.
I was very upset. I was very attached to that firefly.
Last year, when David visited us last summer, and I had this thought that we should all go kayaking under a full moon down the Haw River, because doesn't that just sound fun?
What an idea.
Man, I thought I was brilliant. So we go kayaking down the Haw River under a full moon, and David was intelligent and got his own kayak, but Elena and I tried to do a double kayak, and maybe I'm just inept, or maybe we just could not keep a rhythm, but we like went in circles a lot. And
we didn't go in circles.
We did to start.
You did not.
We did so. And
no.
Then we drifted from one side of the river to the other, and it was getting exhausting, and as we were finally coming back from this like 5 hour long jaunt where I thought my arms were just going to fall off, I'm really strong and I have a lot of endurance, but even I have a limit. And as we're coming back downriver, Elena spots a firefly drowning in the water, so she was determined to save it. We saved it. Well, she saved it.
And you yelled at me the whole time.
Well, that's because at one point, then, like, she lost the firefly again, and she got out of the kayak in the middle of the river.
Oh my gosh, Elena.
It was, like, pitch black, and
I don't even care about bugs.
I was afraid she was going to walk off a sandbar into some depths or into, like, a jagged tree lurking beneath the surface. I didn't know. And
worth it.
And we also really needed to get back because we were losing the rest of the group. And, I mean, the river only goes one way, you know what I mean? But still, we didn't know where to get out. Mm-hmm. And I didn't want to, like, walk up in someone's yard and be like, yo. So I yelled at Elena, get rid of the damn firefly! And apparently this was memorable.
I had a firefly friend for the rest of the trip. It was too wet to fly, so it just hung out.
She needs to sort out her priorities.
My priorities are firefly friends. Black Cat Blight says, Yamino, you commented on a picture about a seagull regarding a fish and chips incident. Can you reshare that story?
Oh, yeah. I got a Tumblr ask maybe from you. Someone asked me about that on Tumblr, and I didn't really have time to elaborate when I got the message. But so I lived in Plymouth, England for a while. I did my master's degree there, so I was there for 2 years. And while I was there, there wasn't really a whole lot to do, especially if you don't have a car. So one of the main things I would do would be to go down to the Barbican, which is this like port area where there's a lot of sailboats and fancy restaurants for tourists and stuff. And one day when I was walking there, I got kind of peckish, so I decided to get some fish and chips. And because I had other stuff I had to do that day when I got home, I decided to walk and eat, which was my first mistake. As I was walking back to my dorm, I felt like I was being watched. You know, sometimes you get that like little prickle on your neck when you just feel like something is watching you. And I looked around and I saw several seagulls perched like on the buildings and the fences and everything around me, and they were all staring very raptly at me, specifically at the package I was holding. I had not opened it yet, but they knew. They knew that there was food inside. And I was like, okay, I'll just keep it closed until I get back to my room, because I don't need to eat it right now. But as I continued walking to my room, I was like, it felt so warm in the package, and I was like, oh, it's probably going to be kind of cold by the time I get back. I'll just eat like 2 or 3 chips, so it'll be fine. So while I'm walking, I open the package just enough to get like 2 chips, and I'm eating them. Of course, that's not enough, so I kept eating more on the way. And every time I looked up, there were more seagulls, and they were following me. Like, they weren't just, like, flying in the sky, but they would flutter from, like, one building to another, and they were amassing into, like, this flock of seagulls. And I was almost back to my dorm,
as I was crossing this plaza next to the train station before I arrived at the steps of my dorm when it happened. It was such a blur, like it happened really quickly, but all I could tell was that this was definitely a practiced, concerted effort, like when wolves hunt in packs. A seagull swooped down into my face and like smacked me with its wings while also knocking my food out of my hands. And before I knew it, there was this cloud just descended on me. Like they were swooping them out of the air before they even had time to hit the ground. And it was just like this cacophony of cawing and feathers and shit in my face. And it was really terrifying. I couldn't tell which way was up. There were just beaks and feathers everywhere.
Aww.
And I just ran. I threw what was left of my food. Like, it had already, like, flown into the air. I maybe had, like, two chips, but I just threw the rest of the food. And I ran for my life back to my dorm.
God.
A torrent of white and pointy orange.
And afterwards, I was so upset, I immediately went online to tell Ash what had happened. And
I remember that.
I made a post about it. I was trying to find the post when people had asked me about it recently, but I can't find the post, but I remember that I wrote about it in a really funny way. And after I wrote this post, all these stories were coming in. Like, people would send me messages. They're like, oh my god, something like that happened to me. And they just were each one was worse than the other. Like, apparently, some people were walking at the beach with their baby, and seagulls thought their baby was a picnic. And they tried to do the same thing to make them drop the baby. That's horrifying.
Oh my god.
Look at that giant burrito, guys!
All bundled up.
But I also
hash.
I just wanted a nice family thing.
It's like baby's first outing at the beach. I don't have a really good track record with seagulls. I remember we also went to the one time that we went to, what's it called, SeaWorld, I was so excited to feed the dolphins because they give you fish and you give meat to the dolphins. And I swear to God, every time I put out a fish for the dolphins to eat, the dolphin would be like just coming out of the water, and the seagull would just snatch it out of my hand. And it got to the point where I would be trying to like punch the seagulls out of the air to keep them away from the fish.
Oh,
I couldn't get a single fish to the dolphins. The seagulls kept snatching them away from me. But yeah, so that's my seagull story.
I remember you were like crying when you came on Skype to tell me what had happened. You were so mad. You're
I
like,
was
they
so
ate my
upset.
Prize. You might have said chips. I
don't
remember.
Yeah.
Dan asks, Elena, are you secretly a seagull witch?
No, but my mom has paid for a cameo in Sister Claire, and she requested to be, like, well, she didn't specifically request this, but I said, the soonest we can put you in would be as a bird witch, so what kind of bird would you like to be? And she was like, I don't know, something that has to do with the ocean. And I was like a seagull? And she's like, yeah, that'd be great. And I was like, you know, I have to write you as an asshole. Like, I'm a seagull. And she's like, that's okay. So apparently some, like, asshole seagull kid is going to be in the comic,
well,
and it'll
already,
be my mom's OC.
There's already Gull.
Well, that's
that
my mom's OC.
Yeah,
Gull.
Gull,
yeah.
Ducat.
Gull's the only person, there's only two people that Gull is nice to, and one of them is Pidge, and the other one is Clementine.
Of course Gull would be friends with the other bully bird,
of course.
Pidge.
I had them be comrades in order.
I really like to imagine that Gull and Pidge team up just like those seagulls did in Plymouth to, like, get food from people.
Someone
asked, they'll attack in a pack.
Someone asked, have you ever actually shown Falcon? We don't have a Falcon, we have Hawk. That might be who you're thinking.
Yeah,
of.
And we have shown Hawk in Hawk form,
yeah,
but
in
not
in
human form.
We may eventually show her in human form.
Mm-hmm. I would like to design her. She has not been designed yet.
I know what she looks like in my head. Her name before she became a bird witch was Priya.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. She's very short and very angry.
No.
So
oh,
she's you.
No, she's not me. I'm not always angry. Oh, you need to
You need to start a new hour recording.
I'm actually almost done with the sketch.
And
so
then you're going to follow up with
me? Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm just going to keep recording until I'm done with the sketch. I can make this one video.
I.
I don't know all the words.
I don't know any of them.
It's weird seeing people online in a similar time zone.
You're in America now, David. You're on America time.
So y'all heard it. Elena will be finishing up soon. So if you have any more questions, please ask them as quick as you can.
Imminently.
Yeah.
Laura asks, do you girls know what kind of hurt gave birth to Snowy?
I don't think... Wait, yeah, we do. It was a sickness that killed a lot of people. Mm-hmm. So it wasn't like... It wasn't war or something. It was a plague created Snowy.
Snowy, like, if you go back and you read...
It's not, like, explicitly mentioned, but it is said that the shard that made Snowy had, like, oozing pus and stuff. It
mm-hmm.
looked very sick.
It looked very sick, and it was about the size of an adult person.
It was also mentioned before that, I think, that a village had been wiped out before, so...
Oh, is this... So it's, like, spoilers.
It's
like,
not spoilers, it's stuff that was...
Snowy, a shard...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you know, that was a while ago. Sorry.
David, yeah,
David,
you
out of the loop.
In other news, Vader is Luke's father.
Someone asks, is the size of the animal relative to the size of the shard, as in purified shards?
Sometimes, I would say it's more like relative to the size of the pain that created it.
Yeah, and not only that, but...
Like, Snowy's shard was pretty big. It was bigger than a cow. Like, it was maybe as big as two cows.
Well, it really depends on when you see the shard that was Snowy twice. And the first time you see it, Oscar stabs it in the orchard. And it looks more like a person than what you eventually see Claire touching in the orchard, like, later that evening. Shards can and do... change in appearance. You saw the big shard do this, like it didn't start out with those creepy, like, spider legs. it was a pretty big one, and it turned into a tiny cat. Yeah. So.
Any last questions before I finish up here?
Someone said, does it produce felines or mammals only? The reason that the shards... Well, the reason that purified or mostly purified shards tend to look like cats is because, well, Clementine was very fond of cats and so was Claire. When Magpie helps,
if Sarah was in their place, they would look like bugs.
They would look like earwigs, let's not
Johnny, and people would
big, cute, rideable earwigs.
But there's also, like... there's something I want to say, but it's kind of spoilery. Like, you've seen another person purify a shard, and that was Magpie. And, I mean, Magpie, what Magpie did didn't look like a cat at all, did it?
Mm-hmm. We'll take one last question.
Aw, someone doesn't want us to finish yet.
Aw, I'm sorry.
We could stay for a little bit longer and ask some more questions. You don't have to answer some more questions. You don't have to draw.
Okay. Well,
I know we still have stuff to do, but
I still need to eat food.
Okay. Well, like I said, you know, we could answer
questions.
And I
need time to digest said food. I mean, we can do another one of these tomorrow, and we can make it earlier, too.
Mm-hmm.
I'll figure that out.
Polly Puppy asked, why did healing the big shard cause Claire's horns to come out, but not healing the one in the missing moments? That's a good question. This kind of goes in with an explanation I put in to the comments last week. Like, someone asked, what happens to the pain of the purified shards? Like, where does it go? It goes into the person doing the healing slash purification. And when Claire absorbed the shard that became Snowy's pain, it wasn't enough that she needed to eject it via horns. It wasn't too much for her to handle such that horns would appear. But if you do recall, it still took a lot out of her. I mean, she slept for a while afterward. But and eventually taking in the big shard was too much for her. So,
what?
This is what people have been trying to avoid. Hence why Catherine and everyone else looks so horrified.
I think I'm going to finish up here. But we can... I can stop the recording and we can just chat a little bit if you guys want.
Okay.
Do you want to say buonanotte to people watching this on YouTube?
Yeah.
Okay.
You should sing.
Okay, we can sing. Yes. So, for those of you watching this on YouTube, thank you for watching, and please consider subscribing to our channel to see a lot more videos like this. And please consider, if you haven't already, checking out our webcomic at sisterclaire.com. And we'll see you next time. Good night. Good night. Good night.
I'm so glad that was you.